on my mind, I can't sleep at night, so I just keep writing. I don't need no help, I don't need opinions, so don't waste my time then. Killing the game and I gotta go ask anybody, they all heard about it. They know when the kid and he's spitting it, know when he getting it, bit and I get in my way. Got this, I like, do whatever I say, cause I could go put you on blast. People been mad at me cause I don't follow them back. I'm laughing cause that is so whack. Why they y'all trying to act like they been bossing when really their boss has been bossing them up? Nobody ever been telling me what I would do when I keep in the cash, ride the shit out of luck. I want them more, now I get what I wish. Upgrading now with some pens that I whip. Making six figures, don't talk about it. Money and shit, it's about how you think. Tired of people who making excuses, then they complain about losing. Tell me about what you been doing, tell me about how you been moving. You ain't got nothing to prove then. I did it all on my own, they looking like all of my clones. I don't be following trends, fuck all the popular clothes. You faking and everyone knows, I just be keeping it real. They thinking that I have to go sign a deal, but really the people just found an appeal. I'm in my own lane and I'm steering the wheel, ayy. It's funny how it goes, funny how it goes. Working every night till the sunrise.
Welcome back once again, season 6, the second to last episode, and this one, for the viewers at home, it's going to be simply untouchable. I got none other than my very good friend, William, known as Karnage, ref on the Indies, doing big things these days. How are you doing, sir?
Surviving.
Well, I am absolutely honored that you decided to do the show with me today. You and I kind of go way back before you came in XCW and then ventured onto the Indies, so.
You're the reason why I joined XCW.
I'm very proud to have you, sir. So, let's get right into it. What has William been up to these days?
Shoot, really. It's a kind of stressful job, but I get to shoot, and then, of course, I try to rep on the Indies as when I can.
So, how's that been going? Like, what's your recent promotions that you've done stuff for?
I got New Era here in Shelbyville, and then I've worked for Greenfield for TJ Kemp at Summit Pro. They only got 2 shows a month right now.
Some other people that have reffed from XCW before, Fletch has also reffed on Indies, along with the late great Kurt Acid, which he'll,
man,
if he was still here, he'd brag about how he got piled driving by Jerry Lawler.
He's the reason why I'd still do it. Yeah. Seriously.
Speaking of him, that's the next question. I have asked everybody this entire season, how has the loss of Benji affected you?
That's a rough one, man. Now, when I left XCW, he's one person that I really kept in touch with. I would ask questions of, because he's the one that trained me to be a ref.
Yeah.
He's the reason why I still do the thing. It still affects me today. You bring him up, obviously.
Yeah. You're not the only one it affects.
I know, bro.
Moving on. You had a stint in XCW for a few years. What was your favorite match that you had the chance to be in? A lot of Karnage history there. Hopefully you don't say where Gurky almost caused you to break my neck.
No, I'm going to have to say winning the world title over Cerebral.
Yeah, winning the world title is great. Me and Josh always talk about how when kayfabe went out with the leg injury for a year, the Untouchables broke up, how you and Jimmy James Cerebral went on to do
bigger and better things. Told me a great story, I thought.
What's the favorite match you've seen in XCW?
In XCW?
Yes.
My favorites were always the King of the Mountains. Those are my favorites.
Interesting aspect.
You can't, yeah.
For the people that might not know, King of the Mountains, similar to ladder match, except you have to get a pinfall and hang the championship up. Here's a question. I have not been involved with you on the Indies. I had my little stint back in the day. And what's your favorite match you've got to see on the Indies? I know you've probably seen a lot.
Sitting in the gorilla is my favorite, though. Watching other dudes I don't get to work with. And then my matches, of course. Lately, TJ Kemp, when he retired, his retirement match was, I told the story. I got to be a part of telling the story. I walked out of the match. If you go back, it's on video. I at US Summit Pro, TJ's last match against Sean. TJ had it won. I didn't want my mentor. Somebody took me on the road and showed me a lot of things and taught me how to tag team ref, how to solo ref, how to listen to the crowd, how to listen. He taught me a lot more than I ever expected. And when he retired, and especially now that he's on the Better Health kick, and he's in his prime now, it feels like, but it's his life, it's his decision. But I think I couldn't count. I got up and walked out the match. That story was something that I'll never forget.
And we're talking about Too Cool TJ Kemp, right?
Sorry.
Clarifying for the people at home. You kind of spoke on it. You said you love to be in Gorilla. Favorite moment you've had on the Indies so far, excluding that. Obviously, that was an important moment for you.
Being in IWA a lot and being in the Gorilla with Jake Crist and Larry D and just sitting there watching, or Tracy Smothers, oh my God. Well, so you go back to my favorite match. I had an opportunity to be in the ring with Tracy Smothers and Chris Hero in the same match.
That's nice.
At Jammers.
That's nice.
In Clarksville. And there was a spot where the heels came out and drawled Chris away after Chris had took off his elbow pad. It was going to do the elbow. They drew me and Chris away.
Yeah.
So they could put ether on Chris's elbow pad. Then Tracy puts it on, puts him to sleep.
Yeah.
And Tracy doesn't let me do the count. He's like, wait for it. Listen to the crowd. And he's talking to me the whole time. The crowd doesn't even know because they're all shitty. And it's just, that was one of my favorite learning experiences. And also I went to Tracy Smothers' camp for a couple pro weekends. It was slept in his ring for overnight. That was.
You mentioned one of the Chris brothers. One of my indie stint, one of my first big matches was with Dave and Jake Chris. So it's kind of interesting that you mentioned them.
I spent a lot of time at Rockstar also. Yeah. There was a time where I was going to Rockstar I went there like 3 months solid repping. So.
Their appearance has quite changed since.
Yes, but Jake's on the up and up. He's starting, I think he's got a spot in AEW coming up maybe soon. So.
They were both, back then, they didn't really have any tattoos. They were both skinny, clean cut. I forget which one. Probably. I can't remember. His name was Lotus back then.
Dave got canceled.
Okay, so.
Yeah. Jake's the only one.
It might have been. But
Jake was Crazy Jay.
Okay, so.
Dave was.
It was
Lotus.
Dave. And then, if you've seen this guy back then, this was way before we'd ever met.
Right.
He looked like, not was, but like appearance wise, looked like the second coming of like Randy Orton, so to speak. Like this clean cut.
Right.
Worst weapon shots you've seen in XCW and on the Indies.
Oh my God. And that Hazard Genocide match that they had, I watched that. That was intense. That would probably be my top.
Yeah.
XCW. Taking a kendo shot from Jake Crist.
He looks like he could swing one really well.
Yeah. I don't know, I got to throw a fireball and flash bang in his face. That was kind of fun.
I've never had the opportunity to throw a fireball. Uh-huh. It seems like it'd be something fun to do.
It is fun to do. I'm telling you.
Something I've always admired about you is when we first met, you were involved with XCW Hall of Famer Logan Whitty's mother. So something I always admired is you were able to step up and be that father figure for Logan. How is your guys' relationship like these days? Because recently, before I let you in, you got inducted to XCW Hall of Fame at your Choice Awards last year, and Logan was there with you. So I'm curious on how the relationship is.
He's my best friend. That's no lie. He's my best friend. Yeah. We go to concerts every year. I call and talk to him, message him all the time. Like, send him funny shit. He'll send me funny shit. He's my best friend.
And it's awesome because,
the next tattoo will be his initials on mom.
Like I said, you got obviously no longer with his mom, but
he's
still there for each other, which is really cool. Yep. I like that.
He still calls me dad.
Worst weapon shot you've ever taken?
Well,
excluding the kendo stick shot, if that was going to be your answer.
See, I don't remember anything XCW really. This is crazy. I have bits and pieces that I remember, but I don't know.
Just worst weapon shot taken all time, then.
think I've really taken one minus Jake Crisp one in the Indies.
All right. So we mentioned, I alluded to when we were talking about your favorite match. There was a moment where you and James Gerke were a tag team for a time. You guys were the Revolution. And you were wrestling against the Dark Carnival. Mm-hmm. The finish was a 3D. Just clean. Just a clean 3D. I told Gerke, don't pull me in. I'll run in. You guys get me up real high. Boom. I look fucking great. Gerke fucking pulls me in. You didn't get a chance to get ready because he pulled me in. And I scorpioned. What was your reaction when you seen that? Because back then we were still doing viewings, when I almost broke my neck due to Gerke.
Well, obviously my relationship with him faded right right then and there. Really, that guy, man.
He is something else these days.
Yeah. I don't know nothing about him these days, but he thought he was going to be a wrestler for a minute, and then...
A lot of people did. And you're the only one still there. I'm assuming your favorite XCW moment might be when you beat James Rubin for the world title. But what is your favorite XCW moment? Obviously, your favorite indie moment would be with your mentor, but your favorite XCW moment?
It wouldn't even be on camera, though.
Doesn't matter.
Remember Chops Fest we had?
I do. There's a question. There's a question about it down here. So the chop. You like the chops?
Yeah. That was like all of us. You know.
Bonding, like, yeah, an initiation, yeah, thing. Last question before the first commercial break. You were brought in an interesting way, and a great story with the. So being essentially the swerve, the crooked ref, starting the Untouchables. So what's your overall feeling about your debut, the beginning of the Untouchables, and what we did to everybody that day and in our reign as the Untouchables together?
It was just great storytelling from beginning to end, I thought. It was...
Till Corey Lee took over.
Well, yeah. But, like, it was... That story... should be watched by everybody, I think.
And ultimately, it did what it was meant to do. It pole vaulted you. You got to, you know, go on and face James Cerebro, another member of the Untouchables for the world title.
Yep.
So, excellent story.
From there to there is the whole story, really. Yeah. So,
excellent storytelling. And with that, we're going to go to our first commercial break.
Here's the pin. Yeah. One, two. What? Time. The ref just flipped off Hazard.
Turn.
What's this? Whoa. The ref's taking the shirt off. He's.
No more. Game's done.
Get it, Roddy.
What?
You guys take on Untouchables? It happened.
Uh-oh,
the ref done turned
heel. Oh! Hazard super kicked. Like the ref's been in on this.
You like that?
Oh, and a super kick to Fletch. The ref's been on this. What have I been telling you? What have I been telling you? The ref was in his pocket. The ref was in his pocket.
full of surprises.
You're going on for 3 months
full
now.
Full surprises yet. I've no called shot. This. I called this.
All I want is a chance, Fletch.
Oh! Oh! There's the rest of the locker room! Oh my god! The rest of the locker room's coming out! Look at this! Everybody's attacking the Untouchables! The Untouchables is getting the upper hand! Oh! Hobbs is not down! Christ is trying to come out and save him! Oh my god, it's Max Destruction! What's Max Destruction doing out here? Oh, he misses! Oh! He gets kicked in the leg and oh! Oh! Woo! Max Destruction taken down. Oh! Brutal shot! The Untouchables is. Oh! Hobbs is starting to get an advantage, but he's knocked back down. The only ones that stand and tall. What's this? What is Chris Jones doing? What is Chris Jones doing? Oh my god, he does powerbomb a young fan! Oh my god! I don't know what to think about this. What's he doing? What? He's getting another fan? What's he doing? What's he doing? Oh, on the cookie sheet! That's an evil cookie sheet, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this. Ladies and gentlemen, I really appreciate you being here for All or Nothing. Tune in. Tune in is our next show, ladies and gentlemen. Get ready.
And we're back. You know, beautiful bean footage of us just beating the shit out of everybody as the Untouchables. Clearly, your mentor, TJ, helped you out a lot on the indies. Who are some of the people that helped you out the most during your time in XCW?
Well, of course you, Benji, Fletch. And without Fletch, I wouldn't be able to tell the stories. You give me the inspiration, I'd go with it. Yeah, but Benji a lot, you, Fletch.
I don't know if you realize how entertaining you were in some of the promos you started cutting after a while. I can't remember, I think I was talking to Fletch, but the promos where you're trying to get Emily Moore fired, some of the most entertaining things I've seen in XCW in a while. Who, in your opinion, is currently the best indie superstar?
Current indie superstar?
Yes. One not signed to a major promotion.
Larry D. Well, no, there's Larry D, Aaron Williams,
Ace Perry.
I feel like Alice Crowley and Billy Joe Starks will be signed very soon. But those are my top five probably.
Who do you think's the worst XCW wrestler of all time?
Max Destruction.
It's funny you mention this because surprisingly we don't get that answer a lot.
What?
But the last episode we had was like one of the first times in a while I've heard somebody say Max Destruction as well, so it's interesting. The best XCW wrestler of all time.
Wrestler?
Yes.
LOL.
We've never had that answer in LOL. The history, no false.
LOL.
LOL, we also, as of recording this, the same day, we also shot Hall of Fame with LOL being formally inducted, which is interesting that you said that. During your time in XCW, was there anybody that you did not like or hate?
There was people I tolerated until I didn't like them no more.
It could just be somebody you just slightly didn't like.
Gurky, of course. I'm on the fence about Corey Lee. I don't know.
I mean, it would not be the first time someone's mentioned him. We mentioned earlier, you referenced the bonding and the chops as one of your favorite moments in XCW. So, there was a day, I don't know if you remember this, but you might. It was just pouring fucking rain. We were supposed to have a practice, like, we were bored, we all wanted to get together, just have a practice, just go over some stuff. And we set the mattresses up in Josh's mom's garage. And like, we did a couple things, but like, we didn't really do a lot because obviously it's concrete under there. It's not safe. So, instead, that was at that period, the newer people, you, a couple other people, was one of the first few times that we had chopped you guys. That was the day that I chopped you three times. No shirt, because you were man enough to take your shirt off, unlike the other people. And on the third chop, I busted a blood vessel. What was your reaction?
I mean, that's what you do for the love of the game. In my opinion, like, if you want to be a part of a business, you got to be able to take and give. I mean, you get to give, but you can't give without taking.
Yeah.
So, by taking it, I'm getting back all the love and respect from everybody in the room.
And then ultimately, eventually, you get to give it.
Yeah.
Yeah. If the new people that we bring in now, if their initiation was to be chopped by everybody, we might not have a roster.
Should take a few at least, I'm just saying.
Oh, I love taking and giving chops. At the memorial show for Benji, I mean, Fletch wrestled whatever one of my last matches. Like, there's no chops plan. As soon as he picks me up, I said, take me to the corner and chop me. And then he got me a couple good times. I'm like, Benji chops better, bitch. And I knew he'd light me up on that third one. If you would have stayed in XCW, who would you have liked to wrestle that you never had the chance to, or would like to wrestle again? Yeah, we actually never really had a thing, did we? Yeah. Fletch never booked that.
No.
On the indies, who would you like to have a chance to wrestle with?
Wrestle?
Yes. That you have not worked with yet.
I mean, ref-wise, there's a lot of guys, but wrestlers, not really. I'm not.
What's your ideal match you'd like to ref? Two superstars, you put them together, that...
On the indies?
Creme de la creme.
Larry D. Aaron Williams, like I said, those two are my top guys. I have no idea why Impact wasted Larry D. He could have went to the moon. He's lost so much. He got put so much into himself, and they just let him go. It was...
All right, this is
Larry D's my top guy, though.
This is any superstar. It can be assigned talent, any superstar. Buck Williams' dream match. Preferably people that are, you know, still wrestling. Obviously, like, some people would love to see Stone Cold wrestle The Rock like it was WrestleMania 19 all over again, but like, kind of still active. Book your dream match.
So many wrestlers out there now, though.
I know.
So saturated.
Obviously, Larry D. I'd assume.
Nah. Man, that's a tough one. Finn Balor, Ace Perry.
Finn Balor, Ace Perry.
Yeah, there you go.
I'd pay to see that.
I would too.
All right, before we start shooting, I told you you get a chance to ask me a question. So this is your opportunity to ask me whatever you'd like to ask me.
Why me?
Why you? What do you mean?
I don't know, like... I was just...
We can come back to it if you need a couple minutes. What kind of hobbies does William have outside wrestling? Obviously, you're a big wrestling fan. We spoke about, you know, you still go to concerts and stuff with Logan.
I mean, I watch wrestling and go to shows and when I can. Really, wrestling and work's all I really got.
Like I mentioned earlier, last year in 2022, at Viewer's Choice Awards in December, you were inducted into the Hall of Fame. I'm like, what does something like that mean to you? Because obviously, you know, we mentioned, like, I brought you in, you went through your time in XCW, and now you're on reffing for Larry D and all these other people that you love to watch. You got to, you know, ref for your idol match, TJ Kemp. So what does something like being inducted into the XCW Hall of Fame mean?
Acknowledgement that my time meant something, that my sweat meant something, that my love meant something, that it was received as well as given back, especially on that night. But I felt it before then, of course.
Yeah, you've always been one of the more superstars that conveyed and would actually like show emotion when it came to certain things in XCW, which is something we always loved about you. What?
It's wrestling without emotion.
Exactly. What is William's future on the indies?
I don't know, man. The shoots. I don't know, man. I gotta find a different shoot or something, because I gotta get back to working a show every weekend. 2 a month is not enough, man. I was working 4 at one point in time, man. I was going Wednesday, I go to Rockstar Pro. Thursday, I go to IWA. Friday, I go to WCWO. Saturday, I have any off show, going wherever I go.
Do all those still run or no?
WCWO does. They've had some cancelment issues. Some people, like Joey's son, and there's whole,
yeah.
I don't know. I haven't went back there since the whole debacle. IWA, of course, doesn't exist no more. Rockstar did, but I don't think they run regularly like they used to. So no. So really, it's a Saturday, every Saturday thing, really.
Is there a particular promotion you'd like to have a chance to work for?
Emerge.
Where's Emerge based out of?
Columbus.
Columbus.
See, the whole time I ref for HBW, which was the other show in Columbus.
Okay.
Which they ran the same day, which was dumb to me.
What is your advice for anybody wanting to get into the industry, and how should they go about it?
First, you gotta know that sacrifices have to be made. Like, above all, you have to sacrifice time and so much energy, so much sweat. I mean, if you look at pictures of me when I, at like 3 months into all that training I was doing, man, I'm just so fat now. Man, I was so lean. I was so like healthy. And that's the dedication, though. I was going every day to the ring, and I was getting at least 2 hours in every day, and hitting the ropes and leaving the sweat imprint every time I took a bump, like sweat. That's, you gotta sacrifice a lot if you really want to get into it and get heavy into it.
How big is respect for you in the industry?
Everything.
Because a lot of people, it doesn't matter if it's, you know, indies, pros, yards, whatever. Sometimes, not every time, but sometimes you'll have people come from other promotions, no matter which stage of wrestling life cycle that it may be, and they might think that they're that hot stuff, so to speak. So respect is super important.
Yeah. I recognize it doesn't shake my hand when I walk in a room.
Last question. What type of legacy do you want to leave behind in XCW, as you're no longer a part, and on the indies? Because obviously, you know, one day we all got to go. So what type of lasting legacy would you like to leave on XCW and the indies?
I get great satisfaction out of being at an indie show and a wrestler asks me, are you my ref tonight? And I said no. And they get the sadness that they get on their face, because I know that they know that I will be there for them, and that the match is going to go perfect because I'm in there with them and they've been there with me and they know me. That respect that I've gotten from people that I never imagined in the world to meet. It all started with coming into the yard. It all started with a friendship. And more friendships came from it, a brethren. And that brotherhood got me to the other brotherhood, got me into the bigger brotherhood, got me where I am today. This, really, this is what I want to be known for.
The heart.
Because if you ain't got it, you might as well just quit.
Heart, motivation, determination. Three adjectives that all describe Karnage, William, as he continues to venture further into the Indies. I want to say thank you for joining me on the second to last episode. No false, this is the final season. Wow. We're closing out with two big people, yourself, XCW Hall of Famer, referee William. And when we go to this final episode, series finale, it might just involve a little E.B.W. See you then.
Too many thoughts in my mind, I can't sleep at night, so I just keep writing. I don't need no help, I don't need opinions, so don't waste my time then. Killing the game and I gotta go ask anybody, they all heard about it. They know when they're kidding, he's spitting it, know when he getting it, bit and I get in my way. Got this, I like to whatever I say, cause I could go put you on blast. People been mad at me cause I don't follow them back. I'm laughing cause that is so whack. Why they all trying to act like they been bossing when really their boss has been bossing them up? Nobody ever been telling me what I would do when I keep in the cash, write the shit out of luck. I want it more, now I get what I wish. Upgrading now with some pens that I whip. Making six figures, don't talk about it. Money and shit, it's about how you think. Tired of people who making excuses, then they complain about losing. Tell me about what you been doing, tell me about how you been moving. You ain't got nothing to prove then. I did it all on my own, they looking like all of my clones. I don't be following trends, fuck all the popular clothes. You faking and everyone knows, I just be keeping it real. They thinking that I have to go sign a deal, but really the people just found an appeal. I'm in my own lane and I'm steering the wheel, ayy. Funny how it goes, funny how it goes. Working every night till the sunrise.